Okay, so in this unit, we're going to read input from our mouse. So if you look at example 5.4 in your Getting Started with Processing book, you'll see a program that looks like this. Now, you'll notice none of this is commented yet, and it really ought to be. So what do we know? We know that this is going to set the size of our window. This is going to set the fill color with transparency, right? So the 0 tells us to be black, and the 102 sets the level of transparency. Remember, that can go from 0, which means to 255. And then smooth means make it all look smooth, and no stroke means no outline. And then in our draw function, we're going to draw an ellipse. You know what that means. And then we've got new special variables. These are special case use variables. You can see the color is different, and that's because it's reading a coordinate for our X position of our mouse and our Y position of our mouse. All right, so it's going to draw our ellipse centered about the point where our mouse is. Not so bad, right? And then you can see we're giving it a size of 9x9, which means it will be a circle. Pretty cool. So let's run that and see how it goes. All right. Now you'll notice when I move my mouse around outside of the box, we don't see anything. But when I put it into the box, it starts drawing a circle everywhere my mouse is. Now you'll see the faster I drag it, the more separated those are. And we'll deal with that a little bit. And you can see if I sit in one spot, we get our black because it's just building up because of the transparency, right? Pretty cool. And so you could, of course, you know, write your name or do whatever you want to do, knowing, of course, that when you leave the box, we're not moving around it anymore. It only knows where our mouse is when our mouse is over our processing window. Okay. The next stage is to modify it slightly. And by that, what we do is we've added a new line to our sketch. Our new line is this one. Background. Now 204, that's our default color. So by default, this line existed inside our setup. But by not putting it there, it just draws that color. By putting it in our draw phase, it will redraw the background every time it comes around. So how will this be different? When I run the sketch this time, we'll see something a little different. You'll notice now I don't get that trailing circle. All I get is the one circle right where I am. Now, drawing order is very important. Okay, so if I were to rearrange this slightly, and by slightly I mean I take the background line and I move it to below the ellipse line and I run it, what we see is this. And no matter where I put this, we don't see anything. What's happening is it's drawing an ellipse and then instantly redrawing the background on top of the ellipse I've drawn. So remember, the order in which things happen inside our draw phase is very important. Okay, so now our first sketch, again, will draw us this very discontinuous line, because if I drag too fast, we end up separating. Well, that's not very satisfying. So in exercise 5.6 in the Getting Started with Processing, we have a different approach. Let's look at this one now, and let's think about commenting it. So we set our window size again. We've already done that. But what do we see different here? This is going to set the line thickness. So by default, line thickness is 1. So what we're saying is make it a little thicker than 1. And now notice we don't have fill, but we have stroke. And we're going to set stroke to have the same values as our fill did in the last one. So we're going to have a little black with transparency so you can see what's going on. It doesn't have to be. You can make it any color you want, really. And then we're going to smooth again to take off all the rough edges. Now this time we're going to draw a line. So we have mouse X and mouse Y. So our coordinates are four parameters. We've got to do our XY, X1, Y1, X2, Y2. So what this is saying is draw our line from where the mouse is to where the mouse was. P mouse means previous. So this means draw a line from where the mouse is right now to where the mouse was the last time through the draw phase. Not so bad, right? So what happens is mouse X and mouse Y tells me where I am, and it sets a value. Then when I get to here, I take whatever value was here and I put it into mouse X or P mouse X. And I take whatever value is in mouse Y and I put it in P mouse Y. And then I look for a new value of X and Y when I get there, when I come around in the draw phase. Pretty cool. So if we run that, we can see how that changes things. Now remember, this is not drawing a little circle. This is drawing a line segment. And that line segment will connect to where I am now to where I was a second ago. So you can see I can still get nice long pieces. Or if I go very slowly, I can get a more continuous. I can get a much more continuous line. Okay, maybe cursive would be a better way to go. But anyway, you get the idea. So again, if I go very fast, we can see we get this spacing. So, and that is how we do some very simple drawing with our mouse in processing.